let's learn how to test software from a concrete problem. Let's suppose you have this customer, and this person wants you to implement a program that converts a Roman numeral, that is in the form of a string, to an integer. And how do Roman numerals work? They are mostly based on letters, and each letter has a correspondent number. For example, I is 1, V is 5, X is 10, L is 50, C is 100, D is 500, and M is 1000. And you can compose the numbers by simply putting letters together. For example, VI is 6, XVI is 16, and etc. And notice that you should do this starting from the largest number to the smallest number. So V, 5, E is 1, the final number is 6. Another example, X, 10, V, 5, I, 1, so 16. But some numbers cannot be represented by that rule. For example, the number 4 is not I, but instead it's IV. Or the number 9, it's not VIII, but it's IX. And this is called the subtractive notation. It happens whenever we have 5s, 10s, 50s, 100s, and etc. So, for example, the number 40 is not XXXX, but it's XL. 90 is XC, and so on and so forth. If you have more questions about Roman numerals, you can actually Google it. The Wikipedia page has a nice explanation about how it works. But now it is your time, or our time as a developer, to implement this program. And my suggestion is create a method that is called convert, that receives a string, the Roman numeral itself, and it returns an integer. That's what I want you to do. And after you finish your implementation, I want you to think about test cases. After all, this course is about testing, right? And these test cases, write them on a piece of paper. And just use your experience as a developer. What would you test here to make sure that this program works perfectly as expected? And do this by means of examples of inputs and expected outputs. So one test case can be I should return 1, VI should return 6, etc., etc. Again, I want you to use your experience and think as much as possible in all possible tests you can and should make. Yeah? Good. Enjoy the challenge.